in the car to Chalmers. Here we go.
Young PhD students or master students, think back of the time when that was you.
Yes.
Did you ever have times when you were uncertain of what you were doing and the purpose of it all, or were you as excited then as you are now?
Well, I think this is a state of mind. I really enjoy what I was doing every day. Of course, when you do something and it doesn't work, at the time you realize it doesn't work, you're not happy at all. So that's certainly true. But it never stopped me to try another way or to ask myself, okay, it doesn't work, I didn't get the time, and then you don't feel very good for some time and then off you go. I mean, this is part of the game. So what, there's something interesting behind your question is the attitudes toward what you're doing, actually. And that's something that I think anyone, and maybe more especially the PhD students, have to learn, is when you start a PhD, usually before you have been a very successful student. So you're expert about exams and you always get good at the exam, that's why you're doing a PhD. And then you enter into a different situation where it's not that defined what you're doing, you don't have that clear objective to go, and you experience something which is called failure. And I think the PhD is the art of getting used to failing. And there's even a senior scientist that has produced what we call a CV of all the failures, and you would be amazed how many times we just fail. Yeah. We do 10 proposals, maybe few only of them will go through, and they're all very good. So you don't understand why you don't get the others. Mm-hmm. So there's this situation where, because you are really at the edge of the knowledge, because there's plenty of very good people like you, you have to get used to failure. And I think a good supervisor is not the one that is telling the students what to do, is the one that is going to tell them how to deal with failure.
And so what kind of advice do you give to young students in cases when they are dry out of ideas?
Well, first, I can't believe they will be dry out of ideas. And if they're really exhausted, I think my first advice is take a break, go to the beach, do something else. Because, I mean, you may have been too focused and your brain is exhausted. And I do myself do that quite often. I mean, there's a time where there's a limit in my work. There's something I don't understand is going to my office and work 8 hours a day. I can't do that. I mean, my level of creativity is maybe 1 hour a day, it's maximum. So you have to, and some days it's just there's not nothing, and other day there's a bit more. And sometimes my very good ideas I'm having is because I'm in my garden or just walking and walking by the river. So the idea of the productions and creativity and lacking of idea is something that can be quite volatile, and you have to grab it when you grab it. So if you feel exhausted, just take a break.
Perfect.
Okay.
Bye-bye. We arrive.